The return of Jet in Kirby Planet Robobot was followed by Yo-Yo earning second place in both copy ability pulls for Kirby Battle Royale. Finally, the injustice is over. Yo-Yo, the classic Kirby Superstar copy ability, has finally returned in glorious 3D, with an emphasis on safe mid-range attacks and a healthy helping of invincibility frames for melee attacks. Your bread and butter when wielding the Yo-Yo is the classic Yo-Yo throw. Throw your Yo-Yo in front of you with a press of the B button to slam anyone in the way for 22 damage. By the way, I'm using my own damage calculation system for all my copy ability analysis. The numbers may be different from the developers, but they're all the same relative to each other no matter which system you're referencing. If official damage values are ever discovered, I'll let you know how to convert my values to the developers in a later video. Yo-Yo Throw is the fastest move Yo-Yo has available. Although it immobilizes you, I'd also regard it as the safest due to its combination of short duration and long reach. The Yo-Yo Throw's path gives you a bit of overhead protection too, but it isn't much. You have better options we'll be covering later. Kirby Star Allies runs at a silky smooth 30 frames per second, so the Yo-Yo Throw's 15 frame duration means you'll be tossing Yo-Yos every half second if you mash B. Well, sort of. You've got one frame of startup and a more prominent 3 frames of end lag on every Yo-Yo throw, so you have 4 frames between every 11 frame throw, about 13 hundredths of a second, so no huge deal, but it's noticeable and can be the difference between a clutch kill and an embarrassing death. There's a bit of an input buffer when pressing buttons during any move's ending, so there's no need to worry about being precise. Mash away and enjoy Yo-Yo Throw's solid 44 damage per second. This is the best you'll get from the trio of traditional Yo-Yo moves. They all deal the same 22 damage. After all, you're just tossing the same Yo-Yo around in different ways, but these different tosses have very different properties and uses. Yo-Yo Up, performed by holding up and pressing B, deploys the Yo-Yo in front of Kirby, then swings it in a full half circle behind him before returning. It doesn't go as far in front of you as Yo-Yo Throw, but that full body coverage is going to keep you safe from smaller enemies and destructible projectiles. You're immobile during Yo-Yo Up, but that's kind of a moot point since you are during the other two Yo-Yo tosses too. It's a move with fantastic coverage, but a hitbox this good doesn't come cheap. A full 20 frames, 2/3 of a second, are required to use Yo-Yo Up. That's 33% more than Yo-Yo Throw, and most of them are given to the 6 frame end lag. That's right, after a Yo-Yo Up, you're a sitting duck for 2/10 of a second. That's twice as long as Yo-Yo Throw. The other 2 frames are thankfully allocated to a longer active hitbox of 13 frames, with Yo-Yo Up keeping the single frame of startup for all Yo-Yo Slinging moves. Using Yo-Yo Up is a tactical decision. Maybe you're surrounded, maybe you're not sure if you can hit a jumping enemy with Yo-Yo Throw. Either way, you're only clocking in 33 damage per second with repeated Yo-Yo Ups. There are better options available if you're going for a quick kill. Speaking of better options for DPS, we're talking about the final move in the trio of Yo-Yo tosses next, Yo-Yo Orbit. Hold down on the directional pad or control stick and quickly tap B to throw the Yo-Yo behind Kirby, then in front of him. With the Yo-Yo's 3D movement, you don't have an active Yo-Yo hitbox out as long as Yo-Yo Up. But there's something important to note here. The Yo-Yo lingers a bit on Kirby's plane and ends up being active for a little less than half a second if you combine its forwards and backwards activity. It's out there for 16 frames in total, so the few frames spent in transit on Kirby's Z-axis really aren't that big of a deal. There are 5 frames of end lag, so that makes a 22 frame move when you factor in the 1 frame of startup. It's 2 frames longer than Yo-Yo Up, but its horizontal coverage is much better thanks to increased distance and longer time spent on Kirby's sides. It may be close to the ground, but if you know your enemies will be too by the time the move reaches them, go with Yo-Yo Orbit if you need to cover both sides. Otherwise, use a Yo-Yo Throw instead. It's quicker, safer, longer. The active frames are all given to a forwards hitbox with generous vertical coverage to catch enemies at the beginning or end of a jump. There's no downside if you only have one side to cover. Can you tell I like Yo-Yo Throw yet? We're talking about Yo-Yo Orbit right now though, and there's one big topic we still need to cover, damage per second. If you've been paying attention, you're probably confused. All 3 Yo-Yo tosses deal 22 damage, and Yo-Yo Orbit is the slowest at 22 frames per use. Its DPS should be 30, right? Well, kind of. I said to quickly tap B to use Yo-Yo Orbit, because holding B will deploy the Yo-Yo in front of Kirby indefinitely for a permanently active hitbox. This move is called Walk the Dog, and the important part is that it combos into Yo-Yo Orbit. When using Walk the Dog, the Yo-Yo takes 6 frames, or 2/10 of a second, to roll on the ground in front of Kirby before stopping in place due to running out of strength. The timing is pretty tight, but if you release B during the first few frames of the Yo-Yo's deployment, Kirby will immediately use Yo-Yo Orbit to be honest, I have no idea if this is intentional or not. It's probably just a quirk with how move inputs work in Kirby Star Allies. So I'll be keeping my eyes open for similar interactions in other copy abilities movesets to cover in future video guides. I don't think it should be, but with Kirby Star Allies receiving many free content updates in the future, it's possible that this will be patched by the time you're watching this. Maybe some copy abilities will even be rebalanced or get additional moves. I'll make notes in the descriptions of each guide to update them if this is ever the case, so make sure to check. Anyways, this quick combo is incredibly powerful. The yo-yo's hitbox is permanently active from the first frame of any yo-yo move, even when it's barely in front of Kirby's hand. You need to be extremely close to an enemy to execute this combo, but here's how it works. You hit an enemy with the first few frames of Walk the Dog as the yo-yo comes out just in front of Kirby. Immediately release B to begin yo-yo orbit. If you're close enough to the enemy, you'll be able to hit them with both Walk the Dog and yo-yo orbit. The timing is tight, but it can differ slightly between uses. This makes DPS hard to estimate, but I believe the maximum total time this combo can use is 25 frames, so you'll be getting a minimum of 50 damage per second. Sort of. You're stringing hits so fast that it's affected by combo scaling, which I'll cover in detail in a video releasing later about advanced combat mechanics in the game. The important thing to note is that repeated use of this combo with no breaks will result in decreased damage, but pulling off two combos in a row is still a potent option. The timing isn't as tricky as I make it sound. Really, just hold B for slightly longer than you'd normally tap it, and you should be able to do the combo. When using Walk the Dog, the first hit deals 22 damage. Maintaining contact with the enemy will repeatedly damage them every 10 frames for exactly 3 hits per second, but the damage per hit quickly decreases due to combo scaling. Prolonged contact with an enemy is less than optimal, and should be disregarded in favor of constantly refreshing the combo scaler by disengaging the enemy in one of two ways. Release B, then press and hold it again, or walk away. Walk the Dog lets you, well, walk the dog. Kirby can freely walk back and forth as long as you continue holding B, with his yo-yo trailing in front of him as he goes. You can only walk, not run, but running everywhere can chip away your health through contact with enemies you didn't notice in a stage that's new to you until it was too late. Keep your wits about you and guard yourself by keeping Walk the Dog up as you proceed forward through a tricky level. Walk the Dog can be prepared in the air for instant deployment upon reaching the ground. It's nice to cover a landing with a persistent hitbox right below Kirby, but it's kind of small, so don't count on it. There are even some rudimentary physics when rolling the yo-yo around that let it drop down a ledge, and even maintain its position should Kirby then walk backwards. In this situation, the yo-yo string will stretch slightly before forcing the yo-yo back into Kirby's hand, ending the attack. It's no Breath of the Wild, but the Walk the Dog physics are a neat little touch. If you're facing off against a long line of minor enemies, this attack is a great option. For example, it makes quick and safe work of the big Waddle Dee containers that release a group of Waddle Dee when broken. Against a boss, it's mainly going to be useful for the yo-yo orbit combo. All the attacks we've discussed so far have zero invincibility frames. Whether you're standing still with a yo-yo throw or waddling along with Walk the Dog, if an attack hits you, you're done for. Well, not really. Kirby is generally pretty generous with enemy damage values, but if you're attempting challenges like the True Arena, avoiding every bit of damage is crucial if you want to see the end. It really adds up. That's where invincibility frames come in. During certain moves for some copy abilities, Kirby is completely invulnerable to almost any attack. I say almost because there are a few attacks throughout the Kirby series that must be dodged. An infamous instant kill move at the end of Planet Robobot's True Arena makes a good example of this. But for the majority of attacks you'll encounter in Kirby Star Allies, the following three moves should be your instant go-to if you're having difficulty traditionally dodging enemy attacks, and the chip damage against your guard is too much to handle. First up on the list is Break Spin. Double tap a horizontal direction to dash, then tap B. Kirby will instantly transition into Break Spin with zero startup frames. He'll then surge forward for a massive 24 frames, 8/10 of a second, before screeching to a halt with 9 crushing frames of end lag. The almost 1/3 of a second of vulnerable end lag is more than compensated for with a full 24 frames of invincibility. Kirby becomes a living hitbox during Break Spin, so you can freely crash into or through enemies while it's active. This is incredibly useful for bosses that rush forwards towards the other side of the screen. Instead of trying to jump over them, try Break Spinning through them. It's a simple and effective option that'll create some space between you and the boss for a chance to breathe. Break Spin isn't just useful for its utility though. It has a big duration at 1.1 seconds per use, which is amplified by another 1/10 of a second because of the double tap input requirement. However, it makes up for this with some serious damage. Break Spin deals many hits as Kirby spins, and if you connect them all, you'll deal an incredible 95 damage. This is the strongest move in Kirby's arsenal that he can use at any time. There's a more damaging one, but it's near impossible to use repeatedly, and you can't use it whenever you want. If you need fast damage per second, Rake Spin is your absolute best move by far at 86. The first and last hits of Rake Spin deal 37 and 33 damage respectively, so make sure you land them all to deal the damage you're looking for. All you need to do is maintain contact with your target. That's not all. Mash B during a Break Spin to rise into the air. Using Break Spin in the air can still get you a vertical boost, but be careful. Break Spin will eliminate all velocity from your jump. You need to use Break Spin at the apex of your jump just before you begin falling to get a boosted jump from the move. Time it correctly and you'll be able to make jumps you'd normally need to use the slow, dash-canceling double jump to clear, which can make your runs faster and more fluid. Yo-Yo isn't a great speedrunning copy ability by any means, but it's still something to keep in mind. With Break Spin's large end lag being its only downside, it's worth noting that all Yo-Yo end lag can be jump canceled. Simply jump at the end of a move's active frames to avoid the immobilizing, vulnerable timeframe at its end. You can pull off some neat, high damage combos by canceling into a quick aerial Yo-Yo throw, so experiment and see what works best for your playstyle. It's important to remember that all Yo-Yo moves still restrict your movement in some way during use. Do not overcommit. Next up is Gazer Spiral. Quickly tap down, then up, then B to execute this powerful move. Kirby spins on the ground for 2 frames of startup before shooting straight upwards while spinning. 2 stars follow his path, creating a double helix behind him. At the spiral's peak, the stars shoot out to Kirby's sides and dissipate as he falls. It's a lot to soak in, let's break it down further. Every 4 frames of his ascent, Kirby creates a separate hitbox for each loop of the double helix. He begins each loop on frames 1, 5, 9, 13, and 17 before shooting the stars out for 10 frames. They linger at their destination for 5 frames before completely disappearing. Each stage of this attack is a separate hit in the Gazer Spiral combo, and altogether they deal 71 damage. It's less than Break Spin's 95, but that's for a few good reasons. First, Gazer Spiral lasts for 37 frames. For 36 of those, 1.2 seconds, Kirby is completely invincible. This is the longest invincibility on command Yo-Yo has available, so don't be afraid to use it liberally. You might be afraid of getting caught in a bad spot once the move ends due to its long duration, but you can actually jump out of it 16 frames of end lag at any time. I say 16 frames because there aren't actually any active hitboxes during Kirby's descent, but he's still invincible for 15 out of those 16. It's really not a big deal at all. Even so, once that 20th frame hits after 2/3 of a second, you can jump off of Gazer's Wild Ride whenever you like. There's no precise timing to it. Once Kirby begins falling, tap B to float away. Make a quick ascent to hit airborne foes high in the sky or avoid deadly attacks. Gazer Spiral may not be the absolute most powerful skill in Yo-Yo's kit, but it has its place, and its place is much appreciated. Yo-Yo Kirby's final move is the Hammer Drop. Along with Gazer Spiral, these are the only 2 moves in Yo-Yo's arsenal that cannot be used in the air. Hammer Drop requires a small, inhalable target such as a minor enemy or a star. Walk up close, really close. Hold up or forwards, and press B. Kirby will grab his target and begin rapidly flashing. That's it. This is Hammer Drop. You're stuck like this forever. Seriously, you can be if you want to. Don't press anything and Kirby will infinitely be immobile, but invincible. You literally can't die while in this stage of Hammer Drop unless something hits you with an unblockable attack. When you feel like playing the game again, tap forwards or backwards to execute the actual Hammer Drop. There's no startup to either phase of Hammer Drop. Kirby will respond immediately and begin slinging his target over his shoulder and onto the ground in the direction you tapped. The swing is active for 21 frames here, but they're distributed rather oddly. Most of the swing's frames are spent on its ends, which gives the swing a feeling of serious weight. After colliding with the ground, the Yo-Yo lingers in place for a whole 5 frames. It's a fantastic touch that I greatly appreciate, but it makes the timing to hit overhead targets a little tight. Nothing too difficult, but worth noting nonetheless. Kirby is invincible during all of this, and both his Yo-Yo and Kirby's body itself are active hitboxes. Upon collision with the ground on frame 14, about half a second, the target immediately ricochets off of it and around the screen. Ricochet is an object state used for multiple copy abilities and will be discussed more thoroughly in a later video on advanced combat mechanics. The essential knowledge here is it bounces around the screen for a few seconds, damaging anything in its path. The exception is if the target collides with a solid enemy such as Wispy Woods during the swing. When colliding with a minor enemy, the swing deals 62 damage and continues its path, but in this case, the target freezes in place for 4 frames to give the collision a nice visual impact, then finally releases itself from the Yo-Yo to ricochet about. In this case, the initial swing will deal the damage the moving projectile normally would. Both the swing and the projectile deal 62 damage, but the projectile won't deal a second hit upon its release. There is a way to squeeze some major extra damage out of Hammer Drop, though. Like I said earlier, Kirby's body is a hitbox too. Contacting an enemy with Kirby's body, then your yo-yo, will deal two separate hits for 114 damage in total in only half a second. It's as crazy as it sounds. It's a niche application due to the combination of Kirby's immobility and the combo requiring physical contact with the enemy. But since you have invincibility during this whole process, it's not too tricky to execute if you know where your enemy is going to be. Grab a target where your enemy will soon move, and once they reach Kirby, launch your attack. Hammer Drop is a fun and satisfying move to use, incredibly safe due to indefinite invincibility and the cross-screen capabilities of a ricocheting target, and best of all, it can output serious damage. It can't be used at any time, and it's not going to get you the quickest kills because of this. But when you're toe-to-toe with a tough boss you just want to beat, don't forget about the situational Hammer Drop. There's a good reason why it can't be used whenever you'd like. Make sure to subscribe for speedrun streams of the True Arena, the main game, and bonus modes, as well as future strategy videos on copy abilities, game mechanics, and other Nintendo games. I'll be making lots more of these videos for every new copy ability in Kirby Star Allies, such as Artist, as well as a few selected others, so let me know in the comments what you'd like to see a video on. Join our partner Discord of over 1,400 members at discord.gg/101leafy or follow me on Twitter at 101leafy so you don't miss a thing. That does it for my analysis of my favorite Kirby copy ability. Thanks for watching.